When I left high school, I did a diploma in computer engineering, so I spent a couple of years learning how computers, the hardware of computer runs, and then I spent 3 or 4 years out in the industry fixing computers. I spent 2 years in Hamilton, and then I went overseas and spent 2 years in Sydney, and I was a hardware engineer. So that was my role, was fixing computers when they broke down. And then after a couple of years of doing that, I realised that there was a really important part of me that was missing. So I stopped working on computers and I returned to Waikato University to learn something that I knew that was inside of me. So it was to learn reo and tikanga. Within the teaching methods that I use and the philosophy that I have, I use, I think, a lot of kaupapa Māori strategies, really. It's almost the attitude I have to learning, to helping my students learn, to the care I have of my students, I think is grounded in the years that I've been with the Māori department and the years that I've been taught and been teaching te reo Māori. Ka hiki te wairua is about making the students feel comfortable and feel uplifted and feel happy and glad to be in your class. So one of the things that I do is that I have rewards for small activities. So that's the peanut slabs. So if a student does something really well or if they answer a quiz really well, the reward can be a peanut slab. It's just about one particular student gets a chance to feel a little bit more special and it just kind of uplifts them. I try and use humour a lot because if I can get the class laughing or smiling, then I know that they're more in a more comfortable place to learn. So I try and crack jokes or find opportunities to use humour. And then, like I said, when I hear the class laughing, then kua hiki te wairua, their spirit has been uplifted and learning for them becomes much more comfortable. A third method I use to kia hiki te wairua to make them feel more comfortable is to do some yo-yo tricks. If I can find examples in some classes where a yo-yo can be used to describe like an algorithm or something like that, then I'll bring the yo-yo along, I'll drop a couple of tricks, and then I'll use that to explain whatever kind of concept or algorithm I'm talking about. And to be fair, a yo-yo doesn't have anything to do with computer science. All the yo-yo really is about is giving the students some other avenue or some other way of remembering what I'm talking about. And it's been quite a case because I've met students 5, 10, even almost 15 years later, and I've talked about how they remembered the class that had the yo-yo and they probably didn't actually remember what the yo-yo was doing, but they remembered the class they had the yo-yo and it's that kind of spark. It's like, that's kia hiki te wairua. I supervise a bunch of students, and before we have our supervision meetings, we always have a couple of rounds of darts. Then everybody is like in a really relaxed, cool state. It's not like he's the teacher and I'm the student. We're all kind of on an even level. It's a much open, easier way to engage with people. So then we engage and then it's just kia hiki te wairua. It's just about lifting the spirits so that we're in a good place to have some conversations. Another one of my methods, kia hihiko te kaupapa, is about finding exciting ways to explain the subject I'm teaching. One of the important aspects of early computer science, early programming, is using selection structures. And so getting the computer to decide whether to take one path or another. And so my classic example is, okay, so it's raining today, I have a question. Do I take my umbrella, do I leave my umbrella at home? So I get up in the morning, look outside the weather. If it's raining, take the umbrella. If it's not raining, I leave the umbrella at home. So that example, I then program in so we can see it in computer coding. So it's taking different strategies, different concepts, and bringing them into the class so that it makes the topic more exciting for the students. The third area that I look at quite, you know, I try and work on quite hard is kia hora te aroha. This is about having empathy and sharing the love with the students, and pretty much just walking along the journey with the students. It's not really my role to teach them specifically about what my passion is. My role is to allow them to find their own passions. And if they can enjoy some aspects of my class and then go away and start searching over those aspects and becoming passionate about them themselves, then that's success.